त्रिधा अभिज्ञत तत् शृणु त्रिधा अभिज्ञत तत् शृणु अधिदैवं अथाध्यात्मं अधिभूतम् इति प्रभुः तथैकं पौरुषं वीर्यं त्रिधाभिद्यत तत्सुनो अथैकं पौरुषं वीर्यं अधिदैवं the controlling entities Atha, now, Adhyatmam, the controlled entities, Adhibhutam, the material bodies, Iti, Das, Prabhu, the Lord. Atha, in this way, Ekam, one only, Paurusham, of His Lordship, Viryam, potency, त्रिधा इन त्री अभिज्ञता डिवाइडेड तद दैट शृणु जस्ट हियर फ्रॉम मी ट्रांसलेशन बाय डिवाइन ग्रेस एसी भक्ति वेदांत स्वामी प्रभुपाद जस्ट हियर फ्रॉम मी हाउ द पोटेंसी ऑफ हिज लॉर्डशिप डिवाइड्स वन इनटू थ्री कॉल्ड द कंट्रोलिंग एंटिटीज द कंट्रोल्ड एंटिटीज एंड द मटीरियल बॉडीज इन द मैनर मेंशनड अबव Please repeat the translation. Just hear from me how the potency of His Lordship divides one into three, called the controlling entities, the controlled entities, and the material bodies, the manner mentioned above. Text 15. अंतःशरीर आकाशात् पुरुषस्य विचेष्टतः ओजस्सहो बलं यज्ञे ततः प्राणो महानसुः Translation From the sky situated within the transcendental body of the manifesting Mahavishnu, sense energy, mental force and bodily strength are all generated, as well as the sum total of the fountainhead of the total living force. Text 16 अनुप्राणन्ति यं प्राणा प्राणन्तं सर्वजन्तुषु अपानन्तं अपानन्ति नरदेवं इवानुगाः Translation As the followers of the king follow their lord, similarly when the total energy is in motion, all other living entities move, and when the total energy stops endeavoring, all other living entities stop sensual activities. Purport by Srila Prabhupada The individual living entities are completely dependent on the total energy of the Supreme Purusha. No one has independent existence, just as no electric lamp has independent effulgence. Each and every electrical instrument depends fully on the total powerhouse. The total powerhouse depends on the reservoir of water for generating electricity. Water depends on the clouds. Clouds depend on the sun. Sun depends on the creation. And the creation depends on the movement of the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Thus, the Supreme Personality of Godhead is the cause of all causes. Thus ends the Bhakti Vrinda Purport. Om Ajnana Timirandasya Jnanarjana Shalakaya Chakshurunmilitam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prishtaya Bhutale Srimate Bhakti Vedanta Swaminitamamine Namaste Saraswate Deve Gauravani Pracharine निर्विशेषा शून्यवादी पाश्चात्यपेक्षिणे जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौरवभक्तवृंद हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे 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 रामा राम राम हरे हरे
श्रीमद्भागवतम एक्सप्लेन्स
the ultimate source of everything. The ultimate source of everything is explained as Krishna, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. How Krishna is a supreme source or ultimate source is being explained in this particular chapter. This is with reference to the creation of this entire material world. How did the creation take place? What is the source of the creation? Who is the ultimate creator? All these questions are answered here by Shukadeva Goswami when Parikshit Maharaj asked these questions. Before Shukadeva Goswami begins to answer the questions, he says in the Bhagavatam there are 10 topics. And the 10th topic, he just calls it Ashraya, the ultimate shelter of everyone and everything. This ultimate shelter is being explained now further in the rest of this chapter. The ultimate shelter, Ashraya, is described as the supreme being, the supreme soul, the supreme source of the cosmic manifestation, as well as its reservoir and winding up. The whole material world is created. It remains for some time. That is, it is maintained. And finally, it is dissolved, destroyed, wound up. So, how is this happening? That is explained with reference to the energy of the Supreme Lord. There is one energy called the material energy. This material energy is employed by the Lord to actually create this entire material world. Now, in the material world, there are three divisions of this energy of the Supreme Lord, called three kinds of purushas, three kinds of persons. That was explained earlier as adhyatmik person, adhidaivik person, and adhibhautik person. Now, who are these three persons? Adhyatmik person is the individual living entity possessing different senses. See, our entire existence in this world is dependent on our senses. It is only through the senses that we are able to perceive things, or only through the senses we can act. Without the senses, the working senses and the senses of perception, we cannot do anything. So, even though I am the individual person separate from the senses, still my existence in this world is dependent on these senses. It's completely dependent on the senses. Now, how these senses are created and how they actually function is briefly being explained in this section of the Bhagavatam. In a later canto, in the third canto, in a discussion between Lord Kapila and his mother Devahuti, the details are given in the form of Sankhya philosophy. But the basic principle that ultimately it is the Supreme Lord Krishna who is the controller, the source, the maintainer, the creator, the destroyer, the reservoir, everything is explained. So we have God, Krishna, who is God's energy, the material energy. This material energy is first of all agitated by the glands of one expansion of Krishna called Mahavishnu. Now Krishna himself is in the spiritual world. He is simply engaged in loving pastimes with his devotees in his personal abode. This is explained in the beginning. Dhamna svena sada nirastha kuhakam satyam param dhimahi. The supreme absolute truth is the supreme person residing in his personal abode, which is free from all material contamination, free from all influence of the illusory energy. But this material world is where the illusory energy influence is happening. And we are in this material world. So what happens in the beginning of the creation? Krishna expands himself as the Purusha, this controlling person, the supreme person in this material world called Mahavishnu. This Mahavishnu, he glances on the material energy which is lying as inert, non-functional entity. He glances and agitates. Then that material energy begins to interact. First of all, the material energy is differentiated into the five elements: earth, water, fire, air and sky. These become the ingredients for the entire creation. Everything that is created is made up of these five elements. Now these five elements have to be combined. For combining these five elements, there are the three gunas, the three modes of material nature, which is the force, or which is the energy which will act on these elements. Now for directing these three gunas to act on the elements, there are three directors called Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva. Brahma is the director of Rajoguna. Vishnu is the director of Sattvaguna and Shiva is the director of Tamoguna. So these three gunas interact according to the direction of the three directors. But the three directors themselves are not independent. Among the three directors, Vishnu is the Lord himself, expansion of the Lord, who is Lord himself. And Shiva is a very special incarnation of the Lord. And Brahma is a living entity who is empowered to direct the Rajoguna. So these three personalities, Brahma, Vishnu and Shiva, they are actually directing exactly according to the will of Krishna. This is explained in the Brahma Samhita, Srishti Sthiti Pralaya Sadhana Shakti Reka. For the creation, maintenance and destruction of this material world, there is one instrument, sadhana. What is that instrument? That instrument is called Durga. Chayeva yasya bhuvanani vibharti Durga. Durga conducts herself exactly according to the will of Govinda. Ichhana rupam api yasya chacheshtate sa. This Durga conducts herself exactly according to the will of Govinda in the matter of creating, maintaining and destroying this entire material creation. Now for Durga to act, Durga is acting through the three gunas. For Durga to act, she is directed by the three directors according to the will of Govinda. So Brahma creates exactly according to the design or will of Krishna, who gives him the intelligence as Paramatma, who gives him the ingredients. Mahavishnu supplies the ingredients for Brahma to create. Then Mahavishnu gives Brahma the skill, the knowledge at the beginning of creation, so that Brahma can create. Now what is Brahma creating? Brahma is simply creating the bodies of all the living entities. That's all Brahma is doing. But Brahma does not do the entire creation completely by himself. He first creates the Prajapatis, the first of each species. And those Prajapatis further create different species. So Brahma creates the Prajapatis, the Prajapatis create the other species of living entities. Now the creation means creating the material body. Now this creating the material body involves combining the five elements and awarding the suitable senses. Senses of perception and senses of action. So for awarding the senses, there is the action of the Virat Purusha. The Virat Purusha is another expansion of another Vishnu called the second Vishnu. This Mahavishnu, he creates the universes in the seed-like stage, seed-like form. Mahavishnu actually, he lies down on one ocean called causal ocean. That causal ocean is actually made up of the water which is the perspiration of Mahavishnu. That is a transcendental water. On that water he lies down and he breathes. In his sleep he is breathing. As he breathes out, that time from his skin holes so many universes come out. Now into each universe which comes out in this way, Mahavishnu expands and enters as another Vishnu form. The form of another Vishnu, he only enters. And then when he enters, the universe begins to develop. That universe actually develops into one huge shell, universal shell. In that universal shell, Garbhodakashayi Vishnu, the second Vishnu, the Vishnu who enters, he fills up with his perspiration called Garbha Udaka. On that water of his own perspiration, he lies down and from his navel one lotus flower comes out. On that lotus flower, Vishnu gives birth to Brahma, the first created living entity in this entire universe. So that Brahma, actually when he is born, he sees only darkness everywhere. By nature, this material universe is filled with darkness. There is no light. Outside the material universe, there is light, which is the light of the effulgence of Krishna's transcendental form called Brahma Jyoti, spiritual light. But inside the universal shell, there is no light. So, this universal shell in which Brahma is actually born, this universal Brahma sees only darkness and he receives direction from Vishnu to actually perform tapasya. Then he performs tapasya and he becomes enlightened. Then he is given the skill also in addition to knowledge, and he is given the ingredients, and those ingredients are combined by Brahma with the skill and the knowledge he has received from Vishnu to actually create the Prajapatis. Now Brahma creates the Prajapatis, but these Prajapatis, in order to do further creation, they are dependent on the manifestation of the Virat Purusha. Because when these personalities are actually taking birth at the beginning of the creation, which is the place for them to take birth, that place is created by an expansion of this Garbhodakashaya Vishnu called the Virat Purusha. The Virat Purusha creates all the different planets. Now these planets seem to come automatically into existence, but actually they are creations of the Virat Purusha. The Virat Purusha actually employs the three gunas, the three modes, acting upon the five elements. And the three modes acting on the five elements, the different planets are created with the different situations for further creation. Brahma is born on the lotus flower that is generated from the navel of Vishnu. But for Brahma to create or to give birth to the Prajapatis require a certain place. So before the Prajapatis are born, the 14 planetary systems come into existence by the action of the Virat Purusha. So the Virat Purusha is actually also the sum total of all the senses of all the living entities. And they get, these senses get differentiated as senses of the living entities, as the living entities taking birth as the Prajapatis, as the species of life who are born after the creation begins. So I may think that I have got a mouth or I have got eyes, but these are not my eyes. This is not my mouth. This is the mouth of the Virat Purusha. These eyes are the eyes of the Virat Purusha. But they have been awarded to me at the time of creation, at the time I take birth as this material body. So creation means awarding the material body. But the material body essentially consists of the senses. And these senses actually belong to the Virat Purusha. And the Virat Purusha actually is giving the individual senses in terms of this body. So the body actually belongs to whom? To the Virat Purusha. So that Virat Purusha is called the Adibhautik person. These senses also collectively, they are belonging to one person. Even though we see the senses distributed among different persons, different individual persons, but the individual persons actually are having them in the form of this material body only. And this material body is given for a certain duration called the span, lifespan, Ayuhu. Every living being has got a lifespan. So what is the significance of lifespan? Lifespan is the time duration when you can have these senses with which you can see, with which you can interact, you can act, with which you can perceive. You see, when this body, we say, death of a person, what is it? These senses are taken away. The senses are taken away means
this body is useless. Actually, body means the senses. But somehow we get a conception or perception that this body is there, apart from that the senses are there. But actually body is nothing but the senses. These senses also actually appear like dead matter. Just like the doctor, if there's some eye problem, the doctor will operate the eyes or do something to the eyes. And what is the ingredient or the substance of the eye as the sense with which we used to see? It is basically matter. Right? But this matter is energized by one energy called prana. That prana is called the life force. That life force is circulating within this body, because of which the body is having senses which I can use, with which I can see, with which I can work. You see? So that prana belongs to, it's the fundamental life force belonging to the Virat Purusha, the Lord who owns all these senses. So when he withdraws that prana, these senses become just dead matter. That is when we say a person dies, when the Lord withdraws that prana. At the time of birth, this prana is injected into the body. And at time of death, the prana is taken away. So senses are merely instruments, and those instruments function because of the prana. And this prana is given at the time of birth by the Lord, and this prana is withdrawn at the time of death by the Lord. This is the actual mechanism that is working. So the Lord who actually owns all these senses is called the Virat Purusha or the Adibhautik person. I, the individual soul who gets this body, who utilizes the senses, who works with the senses, I am called the Adhyatmik person. And there is a controlling deity, just like the eye movement. The eye movement is controlled by one devata, another person called the Adidaivik person. Adidaivik person is the controlling entity. Controlled entity, controlling entity, and the senses. Three kinds of persons. Adidaivik, Adhyatmik, Adibhautik. The senses are required as the instrument, and the person who utilizes the senses is called the Adhyatmik person. And there is the controller of these senses, individual senses, in terms of managing the movement or the functioning that is given to a controlling deity. For each of the senses, there is a controlling deity. And that will be explained in the later verses here. For now, the principle is explained that there are three kinds of persons, and all three persons are actually coming into existence because of the creation by the Lord as Vishnu. So at the beginning of the creation, what is happening? Vishnu is employing the material energy for the creation, and the living entities who are coming into this material world, taking birth, they are all individual souls who are actually injected into this material energy by the glance of Mahavishnu only. That is also explained in the Bhagavad Gita in the 14th chapter, that Sarva yonishu kaunteya murtaya sambhavantiyaha tasam brahma mahadyonir aham bija pradapita. Krishna says, I am the seed giving father as Vishnu. The seed that is injected is the living entity, the spirit soul. And injected into what? Into material nature, which is like the womb in which the living entity is taking birth. that womb of the birth of the living entities is actually material nature. That material nature is the material energy on which Mahavishnu is glancing. So we take birth means we are getting this body. But getting the body, we should understand, is nothing but actually acquiring the senses through which we can act or through which we can perceive. So this is one perspective of the creation. Now the creation itself can be seen from different perspectives, because creation is a very complex thing, it's not so simple. So one perspective is how the Lord is the creator, how the Lord is the maintainer, how the Lord is the destroyer. So from this perspective, how is the Lord creator? He injects the prana after awarding the senses to the living entity at the time of birth. And as long as this pranavayu circulation is going on in the body, by the arrangement of the Lord as Paramatma, he is seated as Paramatma, and by his arrangement this pranavayu circulation is going on. So that is the maintenance. And the destruction happens when the pranavayu is withdrawn, then this body is useless lump of matter. That's all. You cannot maintain this body anymore. Nobody can maintain the body. The body disintegrates into the five elements. That's all. So the pranavayu is withdrawn. All the senses are merely matter after that. And the senses or the matter goes back to the reservoir of earth, water, fire and sky, from which it is taken and it is produced at the beginning. So the perspective of creation, Vishnu actually is injecting this pranavayu, he is giving the senses, he is maintaining this pranavayu circulation, and he withdraws the pranavayu, and all the elements disintegrate into the different elements themselves, the body disintegrates. So this is one perspective of creation, maintenance, destruction, and we can understand how Vishnu is the creator, Vishnu is the maintainer, Vishnu is the destroyer, and that Vishnu is an expansion of Krishna. Therefore, Krishna is the ultimate source, ultimate cause of the entire creation, maintenance, destruction in this world. So this is one perspective that is presented in this chapter. Let's start with Gadra Srinath Bhagavatam Kijaya Shraddha Upadhyaya.